Dear students, today I am going to explain the next subtopic from the distribution law, that is extraction with a solvent. See towards the PPT. These are the some basic diagrams for the simple extraction. Extraction with a solvent is a most important technique to separate the dissolved organic substance from the aqueous layer. Whenever one of the organic substance is dissolved into the water layer, how it can be extracted or separated from that layer, that is our interest. And for that purpose, we must have to learn this extraction technique by using the distribution law. In this extraction with a solvent method, we are adding another solvent as like ether. Whenever ether is added to a water layer in which the organic substance is present, and after vigorous shaking and on standing, what happens? These two, ether layer and water layer, they are completely immiscible with each other. But the organic substance which is in a dissolved state in the aqueous layer, that will show the distribution itself, or it gets distributed itself into the ether layer. Being the distribution ratio is more in favor with the ether, more and more substance, that is dissolved organic substance, goes into the ether layer. Then aqueous layer or the water layer is taken in another beaker and left out ether layer in which the dissolved organic substance is now present due to being it is distributed from the water layer in it, that is taken into the another beaker. After distillation of this ether layer, ether will be distilled off and organic substance will left at the bottom. In this way, in the simple extraction, we could separate the dissolved organic substance from the aqueous layer by adding another organic solvent which is completely immiscible with the aqueous layer, but whatever the organic substance which is in a dissolved condition, that will be distributed into the ether layer also. Then see with the content. The extraction of organic substance from an aqueous solution is probably the most important application of distribution law. The process is carried out by shaking the aqueous solution with a immiscible organic solvent, say ether, in a separatory funnel. The distribution ratio being in favor of ether, most of the substance passes into ether layer. On standing, the aqueous and ether layers separate in the funnel. The lower aqueous layer is run out, leaving the ether layer behind. This ether layer is then transferred into a distillation flask. Ether is distilled over while the organic substance is left as a residue in the flask. If desired, the process may be repeated with aqueous layer left behind after the first extraction with a fresh quantity of the solvent. The other common solvents used for extraction are hexane, benzene, chloroform, acetone, carbon disulfide, etc. etc. The greater the distribution ratio is in favor of the organic solvent, the greater will be the amount extracted in any operation. Then we have to see the multiple extraction. In this multiple extraction, whatever the quantity of organic solvent which is provided, that is 100 ml for the 100 ml aqueous layer, and the distribution ratio is twice in favor with the ether layer. Whatever the quantity of the ether layer which is provided to us, that is 100 ml, we may use that 100 ml ether in a single lot or in multiple lots also, or 2 lots, 4 lots, 5 lots in this way. In this case, we are studying the what much quantity of the organic substance is going to be extracted whenever we are using the ether layer or ether as a solvent in a single lot, that is 100 ml in a first lot. Then in the second method, we will make the two portions of that 100 ml ether as 50 ml and 50 ml. And then by using that 50 ml lots separately, we have to find out what much quantity of the ether is going to be extracted, organic substance is to be extracted in that method. Whenever we are using ether in a single lot, then what much quantity of the dissolved organic substance can be removed or extracted from water layer, that we have to see. Let x grams be the weight of the organic substance dissolved in 100 ml ether. Amount of organic substance left behind in water layer is equal to A minus x grams. Concentration of A in ether layer is equal to x upon 100. Concentration of A is the organic substance which is dissolved in the water layer. Concentration of A in water layer is equal to A minus x upon 100 gram. Then the concentration of ether upon concentration of water is equal to K. That is the distribution law. By putting the concentration of ether, concentration of organic substance A in ether layer and concentration of organic substance in water layer, that putting that quantities in the given formula, we will get x upon 100 upon A minus x upon 100 is equal to 2. After solving, we will get the value of x, that is x is equal to 2 by 3 of A. Means 66% of organic substance can be extracted, or we are in a position to extract the 66% whenever we are using the 100 ml ether in one lot. Then we have to see the another case, use of 250 ml each lots. Whenever we are using the 100 ml ether in the two lots, 50 ml ether in each lot, what much quantity of the organic substance can be removed, can be extracted, that we have to see. A first 50 ml lot. Whenever we are using the first 50 ml lot for the extraction, let x 1 grams be the weight of organic substance dissolved in 50 ml ether. Means x 1 gram be the weight of organic substance which itself gets distributed into the ether layer, 50 ml ether layer. Amount of organic substance left behind in water layer. Amount of substance in the water layer in the beginning is A, and amount of substance extracted in the 50 ml ether is X1. Hence, the left out substance in water layer will be A minus X1 grams. So, concentration of A in ether layer is X1 upon 50. Being in this case, we are using the 50 ml of ether in a first lot, and X1 be the quantity of the organic substance which itself gets distributed into the ether layer, and hence the concentration of substance A in ether layer will be X1 upon 50. Concentration of A in water layer, which is left behind, that is A minus X1. A is the initial quantity of the substance, and X1 is the quantity which is distributed into the ether layer. And hence, the left out quantity of A in the water layer will be A minus X1 upon 100. Then, concentration of ether, concentration of organic substance in ether layer upon concentration of organic substance in water layer is equal to 2 as per the distribution law. Then, concentration of substance A in ether layer and concentration of A in water layer, these two values are kept in the given formula. Then after solving, the answer is X1 is equal to 1 by 2 A, means half of the quantity of the dissolved organic substance can be extracted whenever we are using the first lot of 50 ml ether. That thus 50% of organic substance is extracted in first lot. Whenever we are using the second lot of 50 ml ether, then let X2 grams be the weight of the organic substance dissolved in another 50 ml ether. Amount of organic substance left behind in water layer is A by 2 minus X2. A by 2, why it is A by 2? Because A by 2 is a quantity of the organic substance which is already extracted in the first lot, and this much quantity is left behind with the water layer. Amongst of that, in this step, X2 grams is also extracted, so that the left out quantity of the organic substance in water layer will be A by 2 minus X2 grams. Therefore, the concentration of A in ether layer is equal to X2 upon 50. Concentration of A in water layer is A by 2 minus X2 upon 100. By putting these values in the distribution law, that is concentration of solute, that is the dissolved organic substance in ether layer upon concentration of organic substance in water layer is equal to 2. Why it is 2? Because the distribution ratio is twice in favor of the ether, and hence we are taking the 2. After solving, X2 is equal to 1 by 4th of A, means 25% of the organic substance is extracted in the second lot. Means in the first lot, we have separated the 50%, and in the second lot, we have extracted the 25% of organic substance. In this way, we could extract 75% of organic substance from aqueous layer by using two lots of 50 ml each ether. In one lot of 100 ml ether, we could extract only 66% of organic substance. Hence, from above, it is clear that multiple extraction is more efficient. However, whatever be the large number of extractions, that may be, but it is not possible to extract whole dissolved substance from aqueous layer, being Every time there may be some distributed substance left in the aqueous layer. Means we can't separate the 100% organic substance from the aqueous layer. Being every time there is a some part of that organic substance will left in the aqueous layer. In this case, this is the 100 ml aqueous layer. In the first lot, we are adding the first lot of 50 ml ether. After vigorous checking, organic substance will get distributed into the ether layer. Then ether water layer and ether layer are made separated here by using the separating funnel. Then for the further extraction, we are using the water for the next extraction, and this ether is used for distillation and extraction of the organic substance in the first lot, in the first extraction. In the second extraction, this water quantity is used, that is 100 ml. And in this water, half of the substance is remained, because half of the organic substance is extracted by the ether. From this A by 2, that is half of the quantity of the organic substance is still behind in the water layer. That we have to separate. For that purpose, we have used the second lot of 50 ml ether in the second lot. We have added the 50 ml of ether in the separating funnel and shaken vigorously. Then once again, what will happen? 1/4 quantity from the substance, of the substance from the aqueous layer, once again distributed into the ether layer. And these two layers are made separated. In this way, we could extract 75% of organic substance from aqueous layer by using two lots of 50 ml each ether. In one lot of 100 ml ether, we could extract only 66% of organic substance. Hence, from above, it is clear that multiple extraction is more efficient. However, whatever be the large number of extractions, that may be, but it is not possible to extract whole dissolved substance from aqueous layer, being every time there may be some distributed substance left in the aqueous layer. Means we can't separate the 100% organic substance from the aqueous layer, being every time there is a some part of that organic substance will left in the aqueous layer. In this case, this is the 100 ml aqueous layer. In the first lot, we are adding the first lot of 50 ml ether. After vigorous checking, organic substance will get distributed into the ether layer. Then ether water layer and ether layer are made separated here by using the separating funnel. Then for the further extraction, we are using the water for the next extraction, and this ether is used for distillation and extraction of the organic substance in the first lot, in the first extraction. In the second extraction, this water quantity is used, that is 100 ml. And in this water, half of the substance is remained, because half of the organic substance is extracted by the ether. From this A by 2, that is half of the quantity of the organic substance is still behind in the water layer. That we have to separate. For that purpose, we have used The second lot of 50 ml ether. In the second lot, we have added the 50 ml of ether in the separating funnel and shaken vigorously. Then once again, what will happen? 1/4 quantity from the substance of the substance from the aqueous layer once again distributed into the ether layer, and these two layers are made separated by the separating funnel. In this way, in the next or the second extraction, we could separate the 1/4 of the total organic substance present in dissolved state in the aqueous layer in the second extraction. Now I am explaining extraction with solvent. This extraction is depend on the distribution law. In the distribution law, solute X is become distributed into the two immiscible liquids, and its concentration in two miscible liquids is measured. That concentration in first immiscible liquid, that is C1, the concentration of solute in the second immiscible liquid or solvent, that is C2, C1 upon C2 is equal to Kd. This is the distribution law. Means in the distribution law, its solubility of the solute X and its concentration is taken under consideration in the two immiscible liquids. The same principle is used in this extraction. This extraction is a process in which whatever the organic substance which are present in aqueous layer, that organic substance is separated with the help of another non-miscible organic solvent. Intention is that to separate out the dissolved organic substance in the aqueous layer. To separate the organic substance which is in a dissolved condition in the aqueous layer, that we have to separate. For that purpose, consider a 100 ml of aqueous layer is present, in which capital A gram of the substance is present. A is a quantity of the organic substance which is present in a aqueous layer. That we have to separate it. Means we have to separate the organic substance dissolved into the aqueous layer. That is, consider a 100 ml of aqueous layer is provided to you, to us, for the experimentation. At the same time, we require the another solvent, that is 100 ml of ether is provided. This ether is not soluble in water. Means ether and water are the two solvents which are completely immiscible with each other. And our intention is that to separate out the organic substance which is in a dissolved state in the aqueous layer. Add this in the, first of all, it is better to see the simple extraction. Add 100 ml of the ether in this way. This is the 100 ml of water.
and 100 ml of ether. In which the organic substance is in a dissolved state. This organic substance we have to separate. If the aqueous layer is 100 ml, in which the organic substance is present, whose total concentration is 8 grams, and we are adding the 100 ml of ether in it. After rigorous shaking and keeping on a stable ground, what will happen? Some quantity of the organic substance will enter into the ether layer. In this case, the distribution ratio is twice in favor of the ether for that organic substance. Then what will happen? More and more quantity of the this organic substance will get distributed into the ether layer. Means, what will happen in this way? And after settling and forming the two separate layers, but in that two separate layers, in the ether layer, more organic substance will get distributed. And some few quantity is also remaining in the water quantity or the aqueous layer. Then remove the water layer first, in which some quantity of the organic substance is present. Keep it aside. Then take the second beaker and collect the ether layer in which the organic substance is in a more quantity. Then distill off the ether layer. Then ether will be distilled off and the organic substance will be left behind in the beaker or in the distillation flask. In this way, we could separate the organic substance which is dissolved in the aqueous layer with the help of organic solvent which is immiscible with the aqueous layer. This is a simple extraction in which we are using the solvent in a single lot. Whenever we are using this 100 ml ether into 50 plus 50 or 25 plus 25 in this way for 4 times or 20 for 5 times and so on, then what will happen? More and more organic substance from the aqueous layer will be separated. Means the multiple extraction using the number of portions of the solvent which is non-miscible in the aqueous layer, more and more substance, organic substance, dissolved organic substance will be separated. Means the multiple extraction will be more effective than that of the simple extraction. Second point, whenever the distribution ratio is more in favor with the organic solvent, then more substance will be separated in the first lot. Then we will see now it is better to see the multiple extraction, how it is going on. In this case, for multiple extraction purpose, consider a 100 ml of aqueous layer in which a grams of organic solvent is dissolved, and we have provided the 100 ml of ether. Then it is our decision whether to use it in a single lot or whether to use in a multiple lots by fractionating it, as like 50 ml plus 50 ml 100 ml, or 25 plus 25 in this way 4 times, that will be 100 ml. Initially we will see how much quantity of the organic substance with the help of ether can be removed whenever we are taking a 100 ml of ether as a single lot. First method, whenever we are using the all 100 ml ether in a single lot, that is the first method, in a single lot. add to this 100 ml of ether, shake vigorously. Then there is a possibility of distribution of the organic substance into ether layer also. Initially, the concentration of organic substance is A, and some of the organic substance is going to be distributed into the ether layer. If the X grams will go in the ether layer, then the concentration of organic substance in ether is equal to X. Whatever the substance that will get distributed into the ether layer, whenever we are using a single lot of 100 ml ether, then the concentration of organic substance in ether is X upon 100. Means X gram of organic substance X is distributed into the ether layer, then the concentration of organic substance in ether is X upon 100 gram. Then the concentration of organic substance in water layer will be A minus X upon 100. Means initially it was A, being the X grams of the organic substance is distributed into the ether layer, that X should be minus here. So the remaining concentration of organic substance in the water layer will be A minus X upon 100. So the concentration of ether upon concentration of water with respect to the organic substance, that we have to see. Concentration of ether is X upon 100 upon A minus X upon 100. By solving it, we will get the X upon 100 into 100 upon A minus X. By cancelling it in this way, the distribution ratio is twice in favor with the ether. So take 2 here is equal to 2. By solving it, we will get the next step in this way. X upon A minus X is equal to 2. Therefore, by solving it, X is equal to 2 into A minus X. Therefore, by solving it, X is equal to 2A minus X. 2A minus 2X. Then by shifting this 2X towards the left side, minus it becomes plus 2X plus X is equal to 2A. Then this will become the 3X is equal to 2A. Then this will become in this way, X is equal to 2 by 3A. Means 2 by 3A means 66% of X is separated in the second method, use of ether in multiple portions. If 50 ml is used in the first step, use of 50 ml ether. Make the 50 ml, 50 ml, two portions of the 100 ml ether. Use the first portion in the first process. Add the 50 ml of ether in the aqueous layer, that is 100 ml aqueous layer, in which a gram of the capital A gram of the substance is present. Being we are using the 50%, 50 ml, consider what are the organic substance which is distributed into the organic solvent, that is ether, as X1, then the concentration of organic substance in ether for the 50 ml only is equal to X1 upon 50, being we are using the 50 ml. Then the concentration of organic substance in water layer, that will be A minus X1 upon 100. Means in the water layer, the concentration of organic substance A is remaining A minus X1. Why it is so? So because minus 1 is distributed into the ether layer. So the remaining concentration of organic substance in the 100 ml aqueous layer will be A minus X1. So use the formula, concentration in ether upon concentration in water of that organic substance is equal to X1 upon 50 upon A minus X1 upon 100. By solving it, it will get in this way: X1 upon 50 into 100 upon X1, 100 upon A minus X1. One thing we have to take under consideration, that is the distribution ratio is twice in favor of the ether. So write down 2 here is equal to 2, here also 2. Then by solving the next step, here it will come the 2, 2 into X1, 2X1 upon A minus X1 is equal to 2. By solving it, 2X1 is equal to, this term will be multiplied there, therefore it becomes the 2A minus 2X1. Then by shifting the terms, 2X1, this minus then will become plus 2X1 is equal to 2A. 2X1 plus 2X1, that will become 4X1. 4X1 is equal to 2A. Then the next step, therefore X1 is equal to 2A upon, this 4 will be divided here. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. Therefore, X1 is equal to 1 by 2A. That is the 50% of A. means 50% of A will be separated whenever we are using a first portion of the 100 ml ether, that is the 50 ml. Whenever we are using the 50 ml as a first portion, then we are in a position to separate out the organic substance from the aqueous layer, that is 50%. Then we have to see the water much quantity can be separated in the second, by using the second lot of the 50 ml ether, that is the B. Use of another 50 ml ether. If H2 distributes in ether, we have added here 50 ml of ether and then shaken vigorously in the first operation. Whatever the aqueous layer left behind, that aqueous layer contains also some quantity of the dissolved organic substance that we have taken in the for the second operation in the next separatory funnel. In this case, A2, that is the half of the organic substance, is left behind in the 100 ml aqueous layer. Half is removed in the ether layer and half is left behind the aqueous layer, that is A/2. From the total concentration, half is remainder. To this aqueous layer, add the another 50 ml of the ether and shake it vigorously, keeping it on standing on a stable ground. Then what will happen? Once again, the remaining organic substance, some substance will get distributed into the ether layer. Being the distribution ratio is more favor, the twice favoring of the ether. In this way, more substance will get distributed. Another quantity of the ether will get distributed into the ether layer, and some quantity still left with the aqueous layer. Then what much quantity of the organic substance is removed, extracted in the second operation, that we have to see. Use of the another 50 ml ether. If X2 distributes in ether in the second lot, then concentration of organic substance in ether will be X2 upon 50, means X2 grams of the organic substance gets distributed into the 50 ml of ether. Then concentration of organic substance in water layer, it will be left in this way. Now the organic substance left behind in the aqueous layer is only A/2, and from that X2 should be subtracted, being it is distributed into the second lot of the ether. Means the remaining concentration of organic substance in the aqueous layer will be A/2 minus X2 upon 100, because that quantity is in 100, this quantity is in only 50 ml. Then concentration of ether upon concentration of water is equal to X2 upon A/2 minus X2. Concentration of water, that concentration of water is A/2 minus X2 upon 100. This will be the quantity of the organic substance which is left still in the aqueous layer. Then by solving it, the distribution ratio is twice in favor of the ether, and hence we have taken the 2. Then by solving X2 upon 50 into 100 upon A/2 minus X2 is equal to 2. Then by solving this, we will get the next step. This will be in this way. Then by solving further steps, we will get the extraction of the organic substance in the second lot. That we have to see. Then by solving it, A minus A by 2 X2. Then this term goes towards that and it will be multiplied by the 2. 2 into X2 is 2X2. 2X2 is equal to 2 into bracket A by 2 minus X2. By solving it, it will becomes in this way, 2x2 is equal to 2a, 2a will be cancelled, it will remain only a. A minus 2 into x2, 2x2. Then by shifting minus 2x2 into towards the left side of the equation, it will become in this way, 2x2 plus 2x2 is equal to a. Then 2x2 plus 2x2 is 4x2. 4x2 is equal to a. Then the next step will be, therefore x2 is equal to, this multiplied by 4 will go towards the denominator. It will become a by 4. Means the 1/4 of the quantity of the organic substance will be separated. That is the 25% will be separated of a. Means in the second lot, in the whenever we are using the multiple extraction, 25% will be separated. Means in this way, whenever we are using the two lots, then total separation we could do, that is the 75%. Means whenever we are using the organic solvent, that is ether, in the two lots of 50 ml and 50 ml, then we are in a position to separate out the organic substance 75%. Whenever we are using the organic substance or the organic solvent, that is ether, in a single lot, that is 100 ml in a single lot, then we are able to separate the 66%. Means whenever the organic solvent is used in a single lot, the concentration of the organic substance which is extracted, that is less as compared with the multiple extractions. Whenever we are doing the two or more than two lots of the solvent, then we could separate the more and more quantity. Whenever we are using the four lots, then we will get the 80%, 80.3%. Whenever we are using the 5 lots, then it will become 83.4% and so on. Whenever we are using the 2 lots, in the 2 lots, then 75% will be separated. Whenever we are making the 4 lots of that solvent, then we are in a position to separate the 80%, 80.2% of the dissolved organic substance. And whenever we are doing the 5 lot and using for the multiple extraction, then we are in a position to separate the 83.8% of the substance from the total percentage, total weight of the organic substance which is dissolved into the aqueous layer. Yes, this is a technique which is based on the distribution law, with which we could separate the dissolved organic substance in the aqueous layer by the help of another organic solvent which is immiscible with each other. Being the organic substance becomes distributed, or it is distributed into the organic solvent.